In this video, I will show you how I'm planning to upgrade my fuel system to get it safer and more reliable. My boat has one engine and two fuel tanks. While the current setup works fine, I have experienced diesel bugs in my tanks before, and trust me, it's no fun when you're out there at sea and your engine fails. So I have decided to make a few improvements to ensure greater safety. Here's how my system is currently set up, and I will show you later how I want to have it in the future. I have one engine and two fuel tanks. Each tank has a drain valve so I can remove condensed water. Fuel flows from the tank into a selector valve, where I can choose which tank the engine draws fuel from. I usually run on both tanks at the same time. From the valve, the fuel flows through a single filter where water and impurities can be separated, and then into the engine. Any unused fuel from the engine is returned to the starboard tank. Now, while this system works, there are two main drawbacks. If one tank gets the fuel bugs and clogs the filter, the engine will stop, even if the other tank has clean fuel. Out at sea, you don't always want to change the filters while your boat is rolling in the waves. Second, the return fuel always goes to the starboard tank. This can cause some issues. If I'm drawing fuel from the port tank, but the return goes to the starboard tank, it can overflow. Worse, if the port tank has the fuel bugs, its return fuel could infect the clean starboard tank. Now I've got two bad tanks instead of one. So here's my plan to solve these problems and make the system safer. I want to install two separate fuel filters, one for each tank. After the filters, there will be a new valve to select which tank the engine draws fuel from. The return line will also have a selector valve, so I can choose which tank receives the return fuel. This setup gives me some advantages. If one filter clogs, I can switch to the other tank and its dedicated filter. The return fuel can go back to the same tank it came from, preventing cross-contamination. I can even balance the boat by directing fuel to the tank with less fuel in it, if I want to do that. By making these changes, I will have a more secure system. If one tank fails, the other tank remains fully functional. Now, what do you think of this solution? Is it smart? Have I missed anything important? Or do you have an even better idea? Let me know in the comments below. I really want to hear your thoughts. And if you'd like to see what happened to me when I had the diesel bugs in my boat, check out the video in the upper right corner now. I hope this inspires you to make your boat safer and more reliable, so you can sail further and enjoy your adventures even more. Don't forget to like and subscribe to get more tips and tricks on boating and sailing. See you next time.